Everyone, I'm Ada from Poison Rock, and I'm with one of the best, let's say, projects ever existed, in my opinion. Nitlan, Natasha, and Anatoly, how are you?
We are well, little tired after today. Crazy day it was. We're driving around
Beautiful.
Our home. We drive to forest, we drive to river, we
all
filmed
beautiful places.
photo shooting and lot of it's crazy day. One time our car was broken and we had a problem with car, but all is okay
it's
now.
the it's the it's the eclipse and the full moon together.
Ah, no, it's a, it's my experience, and it's Russian car, so it's, I think it's
Italian cars don't are the best in our road, because we are the road full of holes. So
yes, the same.
It's not the best. Even in the countryside, it's sometimes it's worse. It looks to be like in really like the eastern Albania and these places. But it's always a beautiful land, so we just appreciate what we have in nature.
Yes.
So it's been a while since we had the first interview. So today I want to, as well, we have Natasha with us, and it's a pleasure for me because I love your voice. I love how you sing. That's really something that goes deep in the, like with the connection with your inner self. It's just, I never found someone like you that have this power of healing and as well like a shaman. Because I want to ask you, to both of you, what means shamanism for both of you?
Sorry, we need to discuss about
it. Yeah, it's okay, it's okay, it's not a problem. It's...
Yes, shamanism. It's yes, for us, it's not religion. It's because we live in Siberia, so yes. Western Siberia, and not only Western Siberia. It's a land of the keep of the ancient traditions, the ancient beliefs. So the people, especially the native tribes, native people living here. It's maybe something like in Canada or something like in Latin America. A lot of the native people who keep their beliefs, their traditions, and the same in Siberia. So you can meet a lot of interesting place, interesting things. So you can meet a lot of the sacred places of, it's not pagan, it's not neo-paganism, it's not, it's tradition.
Shamanism, it is not religion.
Yes.
Yeah,
it's
exactly.
It's lifestyle. Yes, it's lifestyle. It's something like the mind.
Opening.
Yes,
the opening of the mind.
Yes, you feel the world, you feel the universe around you, something live. So nature, it's a big leaf, big life. So it's we are just part of this great universe.
So that's
shamanism. It's a complex of the rituals. We respecting nature around us.
Okay, yeah, that's the best way to explain it. Always respect nature around you. Always,
yes.
Because
most important. So it's not. Yeah. We don't feel the gods like the people. You know, they're like the
statue.
Yes. So for us the gods and spirits, it's around us, in our breath, in the trees,
in the river flowing.
And it's a lot of different interesting things, and every time we making something new, and we teaching from this, we took lessons from rivers, from birds, from animals.
That's important. Yeah, because we are the guest of the earth, of the nature.
We're just small part of this, and cannot be masters of this.
We should get respect to the wild animals, because we are the same level. Everyone is on the same level. is something that
maybe sometimes we are a little lower level than animals.
Yeah. That sometimes that the Western society do not understand. In Italy, right now they are trying to kill a bear that accidentally killed a poor human being, of course. But you know, people from just go to reach the bear, maybe to take picture or to go running in their own place.
Oh, we have the same and here too. We have the rich people who hunt him just for fun.
They want to kill him for revenge because he's a mom. She attacked the bear and killed this guy, and instead maybe move the bear in a place where she could be safe. They were trying to kill and process like a human, like with a judge, the court. It's something really almost unbelievable that you're making a trial to an animal. So we are moving right now, and I'm, you know, there is this anger inside of you that you want to do something, but what? Just you can go there and say you're, but it's the bad government we have. I think all the West is like that mainly. But speaking about your music, which is not just music, it's something else. I don't know how to explain it. I should ask to people that I make shamanic journey with, what is it? Because they saw jaguar, they saw bears, they saw eagle. What I do with your music, so they saw a lot of animals. I don't know if there is connection, but last time we did an interview, of course, you released Ritual. Ritual is something pure amazing, and there is a lot of a deep, it's like ritual at his own soul. I use it for dancing. In your opinion, and ritual, what is it?
Yes, what it's do you ask about the album and music or about the ritual?
No, the album Ritual. What it doesn't mean.
About album, yes?
Yes.
Yes, for us this album Ritual, it's something like the new part of our new level of our music, because Ritual, it's something, it's the most interesting, the Ritual, the first album, the Natasha working, composed all album composed by Natasha, because before this album, usually it was my work with music and Natasha singing some songs. But in Ritual, it was we tried to make a new experiment. Yes. I gave all deals to Natasha, and I think she made something perfect for me. It's perfect.
Yeah, something like one of a kind. Yes. Really, one in a kind. It's for all and the natural, the therapist, I think it could be a tool to guide, you know, people. And but as well, you did something, you know, like in the folk scene, if you want to see folk scene, because as well, using the word folk is becoming too much misconception of the word folk. But if we say you did like Blood of the West, you know, this changing of doing something more country. Well, how so? How? Why? I mean, because it's beautiful and it's seeing you like in a different way as well, but as well with the same deep roots of this spiritual, this ritual soul as well. So why did you choose to do this country version?
It's we have
a lot of time.
Yes, we had a lot of time. No, we not only listen to folk music and different from our childhood, we had a lot of favorite musical styles. And one of these, it's blues and folk rock. It's for us the Blood of the West Ritual. Yeah. It's not so country and blues. For us, it's more close to American folk rock, American folk music. So you know that American American folk, it's meaning the different from the European folk. So American folk music, it's Bob Dylan, it's Johnny Cash.
Exactly.
Yes. So and Blood of the West, it's our respect for the for people who making the folk music in the West. So, and especially the second important things, the Siberia, the history of Siberia, it's very similar like the Northern America. It's the same, it's the people coming here in the late of 17th century. The people from European people coming here, Russian, so like there's similar like in America, because in America, to Northern America, people a lot of people start travel there in the late of 16th century.
And
to Siberia, it was late of 16th and early 17th century. And the history there very similar. The same day tribes living here with their own culture, their own tradition, and the people coming here with their new tradition. It's the same. The wars between the native tribes, between the people coming, new people coming. The same. The cowboys and very similar history.
Yeah.
And yes, and we're living in Western Siberia, and Blood of the West, it's about the our Western Siberian blood ask us to make this album.
It's like, but it's beautiful because as well you're showing a side of Siberia that it's always been, you know, like it's like America. For people that is in the between, like the European people, we always have an idea of you know, the Native Americans or of United States. We have an idea of Siberia that it's not how it is in reality. Like as well, for example, I live in Sicily, and everyone has that in the idea of Sicily connected to something that is gone. Like we are the Al Padrino, Il Padrino. There's no. So I understand kind of. Sometimes, you know, when you took some picture of the nature and put it on the social media, people say, oh, where are you? I'm in Sicily. Oh, do you have mountains? I guess. Do you have castle? Do you have lakes? No, I just live in that. Of course I have. It's like if I would ask you, do you have guys mountains in Siberia or is just ice?
Oh, we live in our place. We live in plains, like the Great Plains. Our territory is Great Plains, and in we filmed the video for next album, for single from next album, and we filmed first video, and we in this video we show in the Great Plains. It's about our plains.
That's beautiful. And of course, since you mentioned the new album, before us going to speak about a little bit about Akovo, because we have to give it to Akovo, like it were different people, the same importance. I mean, so new album. In what could you say? What can you say about this new album? Because I had no idea. So for me, it's like a news, like new album. What?
We don't know too, because we just Natasha finished new album. Yes, I helped to Natasha for mixing, for mastering new album.
So you already worked on the album, so the songs are ready.
Yes, the album already finished, and we already sent album to a label, so we are waiting for release dates. So, and yes,
that's amazing. So that's gonna be is it different from a ritual?
Not so very different, I think. New album have the something similar.
Okay.
I think because Natasha composed this album too, and it will be the same
energy, same sound.
Yeah, the same energy, the same moods.
Okay.
But with the new ideas, it will be more about Siberia, about shamanic. It will be more, yes, because new album. more Siberian traditional shamanism.
Like the folklore, like the anthropology side,
yes,
of Siberia, yeah, which is important.
Yes. Yes, already. Of course, we pay respect in your album. We will pay respect again for Scandinavian, for Nordic, for our Nordic interests
interest,
of this experience.
Yeah.
Yes, of course. But it's more than 50%. It will be the Siberian.
Yeah, but it's important, like I said, keep your own as well, your own origin, your own roots in the music, because there's a lot of northern music going on, so we need our culture.
Yes, because it's very popular. It's like right now, as we see, it's a fashion, the Vikings.
Yeah, that's why I'm asking.
Everyone wants to be a Viking.
Yeah, that's why I wanted to be different. I'm asking to someone to join me playing. Can we speak about Greek? Because in Sicily we have Greeks and mythology. No one is making folk about Greece. So I said, just came with you, please. But it's not easy because everyone wants to, we want to be Vikings still.
Yes.
And there will be some chance to see you playing live this year, summer. Because I know that you have something in South America, maybe.
We will play live in 2 weeks in France.
Okay.
In Motocultor Warm Up Festival.
Well, that, which is, yeah.
Yes, and as I remember, yes, and in Latin America.
Okay.
In the late of May and the and early June, we will play in Latin America, and I think it's all. Because we will work, we have a lot of work ahead for new album, for videos, for preparing the singles, and it's a lot of work.
I remember last year, and I was supposed to be there at French Viking Fest in France.
Mm-hmm.
Met you.
I was supposed
to be there, and I saw the picture all enjoying with Jonas, Shell. I was like, I'm the only one missing. I was like angry at myself.
Oh, we're planning to back to French Viking Festival this year too.
Again? Yeah. Okay, we're gonna see you there. Okay.
Okay.
I wanna keep the drum. I wanna play with you, Natasha, in the free time.
Okay.
We have
plans, but we don't know what will be.
Yeah.
Because it may be something.
Yeah.
Maybe something changes or something.
Yeah, of course.
But we already plan and we already working on this, but we don't know. We very hope we will do.
Yeah. And about now, act of. Because many people still think sometimes there is a different people, and then they saw there is still both of you. So.
Oh, so it's the same, Natasha.
Yeah. So if you, because I asked you these things in the previous interview, but I want to again say it because there was released a single 9-10 days ago. Torum Ma, is it right?
Yes.
Okay. So Ak Ovu, what essentially is about this side project?
Ну, это только сибирская традиция.
Да, ну что мы скандинавщина по-братскому?
Ну, пока говорю, что это сибирская
традиция. Хорошо. It's Natasha. It's Natasha's ideas. Yes, Akhovu, it's something... It's only Siberian.
Okay, so
it's without the Scandinavian, without Nordic, it's only Siberian. So we're working only with in Akhovu. So for now, maybe for future we will take
but
also
the all in the lyrics items. Or as well if you use I don't know if it's as well, you know, for the folklore music or the instruments.
But, it's in music, it's yes, and lyrics for Akhovu, Natasha
I write it.
Yes, Natasha writing for future, we don't know, maybe it will be also something Vikings, Nordic. But for now, it's in ideas.
Your own music, it's perfect.
No. It's in any case, it will be our own music. In any case, it will have our own lyrics. And Akhovu is something for us for now. Akhovu is something between the Netherlands, and we also have another project, Kyberspace. Yes. And
okay.
Yes.
I'm going to listen after.
You didn't know.
I wanted to listen later. Okay, I need something to do.
We already released two albums.
Okay, that's something big. It's always just you and Natalia, both of you.
Oh, Natalia.
It is only my approach.
Yes, Kyberspace. I'm not.
So what is about? I mean, it's always.
It's industrial. It's industrial, dark electro industrial music. It's folk, Russian folk music.
I find my favorite project now.
Okay, maybe it's something like the Rammstein on Russian language.
It is Russian fairy tales in industrial.
Yes, industrial music, something like that.
So you released with two albums.
Already two albums, yes.
And it's about like you say, tell story about the culture and the folklore put it into.
Yes. Yes. In myths and legends, fairy tales.
Yes. So I think to understand there is a little bit of background music from industrial music.
Yes, it's only industrial. So Natasha singing, and we had the several videos. We film it. Yes. And you will find it's very different from Netherlands. Very different.
But you know, there is always, I think, something that you can recognize, because the spirit, the people who wrote that is always the same. Until we don't transform, you know, like in another animal, we don't transmute in other animals. We are always the same spirit.
Yes, because in any case, it's folk. Because Natasha used the same sort singing, the folklore singing in this, but it's only just realized with another energy in music.
But it's like something as well new. You have this amazing, as Netherlands in general, all about you have this amazing skill of creating something new, because that I don't see in a band, you know, there are so this huge Northern folk band with a thousand of people on the stage. You're just, both of you, and you do everything, like all ritual itself, really. A ritual, this really. I don't know how can you do it. I mean, I will do a cover band of Netherlands.
Sometimes we have a lot of time, a lot of free time. So, and Natasha just sitting in our studio and making new music.
Yeah, but it's really amazing. And I think as well, Natasha, you have this vocal skill. I mean, you're amazing. You're just because the first time I asked to Anatoly that you're is a musical influences. So now ask to you your musical influences.
Rammstein.
Okay.
It is my favorite. But I don't like to listen different music. I don't like listening music. I like to spend my time in the nature, in the forest. I don't like big cities because it is very noisy for me.
Exactly.
And my inspiration, it is nature. It is silence and как спокойствие. Relaxing. I don't know.
More people, less we are, better it is. Like two people and that's enough. Yeah, that's I mean, and before we just ending the interview, so we will have the chance to see you as well, like you said, perform I don't know, in Europe in the next couple of weeks, a Motocultur, and or this summer we will have the chance, because of course there is a first meet. I want to see you playing live and meet you, and this time have fun, because I couldn't. And there is Dini's new album. You think that it will be released before, I don't know, the summer or during the summer, the album, or it's more like winter, autumn?
We don't know yet, because we are waiting from our label, because we Neatland, it's a band working with the Napalm Records.
Okay.
Yes, and we are waiting the answer from label. So and announcement from label. So and only after official announcement we can say.
Yeah, of course. Yes, of course. And like I was saying, the one of the main influence for you is nature. So, what nature actually means for you? Like, because I remember that as well. Natalie, if I'm not wrong, correct me if I'm wrong. That you, in the first interview, you said that you sometimes used to record the sound of the nature.
Yes. Yes. You will hear in next album the lot of our nature. Yes.
So that's something, because and how it works, this process of recording the sound and putting to the music. Because when I try to explain this to some people, they just think that you took like a recorder, you record the leaves or the wind and that's it. It's how is the process?
Yes, Natasha, I remember the when I ran in for the crows with the recorder for saying yes. Yes, we have, you know, I don't know, because we live in small, very, very small town in Siberia. So for us, it's nature, a lot of nature around us. Today was the photographer came here from the big city to make for us the promo photo set for next album. Yes, and we pick up her and drive around our places, and she, oh, so beautiful, and so beautiful in Siberia. Yes, what a problem, it's our land, you just
came from
a lot of beautiful places. Yes, and for girl from the big city, just 100 kilometers from us, it's 1 hour by the car.
Yeah,
it's not so far, and for this girl it is something something unreal. So she come into something fantasy world, like Lord of the Rings or something, yeah. Like the Avatar, you know. She opened for something, lot of something new in our nature.
Because it's
your nature the same, because the people.
And,
but for us, for Natasha, for me, for our son, this nature around it, it's a normal.
Yeah,
so I think for you the same. The nature around you, it's
I have to drive 1 hour to be in the forest, but when I saw to the people, we have a waterfall into some, you know, some city, countries to some country, small city. People are like, what? It is real? Yes, you have just out there, and maybe it's a little bit different because there are mountains and it's hard to go, you know, maybe in the top you have to, but you can find even some rivers, most.
Yes, you just need you just need to start hearing and see. And the same about the nature in our music. The same, you just need to start to hear. We need to record the crows. We just took the recorder, we go into the place where there are a lot of crows living.
Okay.
And we just staying and waiting. And the crows in the evening, usually at the evening, they start to flying.
What?
To find the food. I don't know, maybe it's something like the time for training, time for something. Yes, and for walking.
This big rings of
big rings.
Yeah.
In one place every day. Yes, and we just go in there and start to try. And you hear, okay, she makes sound in 100 meters from me. I am running there with recorder. I'm running there. Just recording this. Sometimes we go in with Natasha to, we have the a few special places for us there. It's something like the sacred places. shamanic places, and we take we know so already there are a lot of birds there, and special sounds of trees, of nature, and winds here, and we just took recorder. We just spent time there in meditation.
Yeah,
we make record and record this sound around us.
So even the sound of nature that you do, you record in your music, it's sacred and that's shamanic ba healing. So even that, okay, I have to move to Siberia. I'm just joking. I mean, it's a beautiful place, but every place, as you know, this special place, like you said, a shamanic place where you can do a sacred, even meditation, but you have to have this open mind to see.
Yes.
People don't.
But
see.
you just need start hearing.
Yeah.
Don't need to try to speak in with the nature. Just sit in, relax, and hear.
That's
and
one.
You will hear.
Yeah.
You will see beautiful around.
That's
you.
One the, of the.
And it's a lot of beautiful.
Yoga. This is called what you mentioned is in a discipline called Shirin Yoku. The bat foresting, and it's called the invitation by fire or by earth, by one of the elements. That you just go in the nature, you sit and you just listen. Which, as Western people, we call it mindfulness, here and now. That's a just simple meditation. Just be aware of its your surrounding. Close your eyes and just start to feel. Even in your skin, you can feel that the wind is changing. There is that's more humidity. So maybe the rain is coming. You can feel a lot just paying attention to what's surrounding you. Yeah. But not all the people in the world are still doing, but I think with the time that will start to change with a little bit. I hope at least in the West, because otherwise I will be really forced to move in the North or somewhere else. At least we are in an island. I live in an island, so people are few people, so we can change them a little bit. That's one of the good things. But I'm really glad to have this chance to interview you, both of you, before we time close the interview. And I hope to see you this summer at the French Fest. Have fun. That's I'm looking forward really to it, to meet all of you, because I know there will be as well Jonas there. You confirmed that. So again, all of you there. And just have a huge party and enjoy the time together. And I will steal you, Natasha, for singing and me playing.
Okay.
And wish you all the best, and really thanks for the music you released. It's really helpful, for at least for me, and I think for a lot of people. But for me, it's always helpful when I need to release everything. There is no one like you in that music scene. And I think you are the biggest, really, in this scene. For me, I'm saying for me, just, but I think for, no, not for the other, but for Ada, really. Thank you so much, and looking forward for the new album. I'm going to listen to Ritual now, and your project.
Okay.
See you soon. Have a nice day.
Thank you. Bye. Have a nice day. Bye.
Främst skulle de ganga och i folkvada Särskilt ni rör er vad hon skriptar.